Community-acquired pneumonia is, as the name suggests, a type of pneumonia that is acquired outside of the hospital. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Pneumonia is an infection that causes inflammation in the lungs and results in fluid buildup, fever, cough, and difficulty breathing. It's caused by a variety of different organisms, including viruses, bacteria, fungi, and even parasites in some cases. When this disease is contracted outside of the hospital, as previously mentioned, it is referred to as community-acquired pneumonia. The other types of pneumonia include hospital-acquired, ventilator-associated, and aspiration pneumonia. As you may have guessed, the specific type of pneumonia is classified according to how the patient acquires the disease. Hospital-acquired pneumonia is when the patient gets it during a hospital stay. Ventilator-associated pneumonia is when it's acquired while the patient is on the mechanical ventilator. And aspiration pneumonia is acquired when a patient aspirates bacteria into the lungs, usually from food saliva or stomach acid. But for this video, we're focusing more on community-acquired pneumonia. In fact, community-acquired pneumonia is actually one of the leading causes of hospitalizations and mortality. It can vary from mild to severe depending on the patient's signs and symptoms. Some examples to look for include a productive cough, fever and chills, tachypnea, shortness of breath, chest pain, diaphoresis, fatigue, and cyanosis. Being able to recognize the signs and symptoms is important for the diagnosis, treatment, and patient outcome. Speaking of treatment, pneumonia in general should be treated on a case-by-case basis. Here are some of the most common treatment methods: antibiotic medications, oxygen therapy, bed rest, airway clearance therapy, hyperinflation therapy, and fluid management. Each patient may require different treatment modalities depending on their signs and symptoms, and in severe cases, intubation and mechanical ventilation may be indicated. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel, and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.